Greetings of the day. My name is Lakshman Jajodia and I welcome you on the e-learning platform of GS College of Commerce, Vardhan. In today's video lecture for BCom part 3rd, that is third year for 6th semester, we are here to discuss about the second unit of Business Finance 2nd, that is Stock Exchanges. In the earlier segment, we have seen what are stock exchange and its functions and its objectives. Later on, we have seen about the NSE, that is our National Stock Exchange, and its objectives and market segment. In this particular video lecture, we will start with the, or we will look after the BSE, that is another popular stock exchange of India, that is Bombay Stock Exchange. So let's begin. Bombay Stock Exchange, popularly known as BSE. We will start with its introduction. The Bombay Stock Exchange of India, or BSE, is a stock exchange which is located in Mumbai. When in the past we will see the Mumbai was known as Bombay. At that point of time, this stock exchange was formed in late 1800s. That is why it was termed as Bombay Stock Exchange, because at that time the Mumbai was known as Bombay. That is why it is Bombay. It is the second largest exchange in India in terms of market capitalization and trading volume. The first one is, as discussed earlier, NSE. BSE is second largest exchange in India in terms of market capitalization and trading volume. It was established in the year 1875 as the Native Share and Stock Brokers Association. Earlier it was named as Native Share and Stock Brokers Association. Later on it was renamed as Bombay Stock Exchange, that is BSE. Before establishment of BSE, that is Native Share and Stock Brokers Association, usually brokers and traders, how they used to trade is quite, we can imagine that what was the situation. They used to gather under a banyan tree to conduct the transactions. This is what the process they have used before the establishment of the stock exchanges in India. In BSE, more than 5,000 companies' shares are being traded. It means that more than 5,000 companies are listed in the BSE. Then, in addition to equity and debt, the Bombay Stock Exchange also allows trading in mutual fund units and derivatives. Apart from shares and debentures, the other securities which are being traded in Bombay Stock Exchange are mutual fund units, that are also perfectly tradable, as well as the derivatives market is also available, so that it has diversified or increased the number of securities which are being traded in the stock exchange. Then BSE is one of the, or I should say, it is the oldest stock exchange in Asia. In the Asia, it is the oldest one, and it contains the third largest amount of listed companies in the world, which is around 4,900 precisely. It means that this much amount of companies are very less listed in any other stock exchange in the world. This is an huge, what we can say, achievement for the stock exchange market of India. The BSE market has around since the 1850s and is the 12th largest exchange in the world. In terms of transaction and in terms of its market capitalization, it is 12th largest stock exchange in the world and ranks second in India. Then it has one main index known as Sensex 30, then Bombay Stock Exchange 30, or the BSC Sensex. What this Sensex is, we can split the term. You can split the term as sensitive index, that is sense, and the second one would be X for exchange. That is sensitive index. This is what is the index which is being used, or which is available in the Bombay Stock Exchange. Then Bombay Stock Exchange was recognized as the exchange under Securities Contract Regulation Act in 1957. So it is recognized under the Securities Contract Regulation Act of 1957. Its benchmark index is Sensitive Index, that is SENSEX, which was launched in 1986, which we usually see when we follow the stocks market, that is Nifty and SENSEX. Nifty is for NSE, that is National Stock Exchange, and SENSEX is for BSE, that is Bombay Stock Exchange. In 1995, Bombay Stock Exchange has launched its automated trading platform known as Bolt. What is Bolt? Bombay Stock Exchange Online Trading System, that is Bolt, which was replaced by Open Outcry System. Earlier, what people used to do, they used to gather on the particular platform or desired space and they used to outcry it. वहाँ पे वो लोग आवाज देके चिल्ला चिल्ला के securities बेचते थे. Later on, this system was replaced by the BSE Online Trading System, that is Bolt. In 2005, exchange changed from being simply an association of brokers and became a corporate entity. As we have discussed in the earlier part, it was an association of brokers. Later on in the 2005, its nature has been changed to the corporate entity because now it has gained very much importance. So it is quite important to make it as a corporate entity in India. Then now we will move to what are the various objectives of Bombay Stock Exchange. As we have discussed in the 14th-15th lecture, that the main objective of any stock exchange is to have the capital formation function, and that is the same objective of the BSE and NSE, that it aims at capital formation. How they would perform the function of capital formation? By way of collecting or mobilizing savings or funds from the investors and investing those funds in the company in form of capital, so that this capital can be pushed for the more productive uses, or it can be made to work for the use which would benefit companies, which would benefit financial market, which would benefit investors as well as nation as well. That is why the main objective of BSE is to provide a base for capital formation. Second thing is market regulation. It provides the function or objective of market regulation. It regulates the market. Then it facilitated trading, that is another function. Why a stock exchange has been established? To facilitate the function of trading. Trading of what? Trading of equities, trading of debt, derivatives, mutual fund units, or any other securities which are being offered on their platform are being traded at Bombay Stock Exchange. Then is the function objective of security, another important objective. When we talk about stock exchanges, they are liable or they should have objective of providing securities to the funds of the investors, because investors' fund are available from their savings, which is hard earned by them. That is why another objective of BSE is to provide security. How they would provide security? Again, they would advocate fair, transparent and efficient system, so that proper communication would be established. Similarly, listing procedure would be quite strict, so that any company which would have any bad intention or misappropriation or does not have proper documentation or intentions would not be allowed to list into the market. And this is how they provide security to the market and the investors. Next is for the transparency. BSE always tries to provide transparency by establishing a proper and appropriate communication network in their financial dealings. They try to communicate real-time information to the all investors which are available to them, so that there would not be any kind of mischievous or inappropriate or any kind of loss of investors. And in this manner, BSE tries to remain transparent to all these towards all the transaction, as they are in financial in nature. This is it for this lecture. In the very next lecture, we will start with the third and last part of our unit 2, that would be capital budgeting. So until then, Stay tuned.
Thank you.